my name's Brandyn Castro. We're here at UCSF in the Helen Diller Cancer Research Building in the lab of Dr. Manish Aghi. Here in this lab, we specifically focus on brain tumor research. Glioblastoma is the brain tumor that we primarily work on. He also does some research on pituitary tumors. And we look at development of chemotherapeutic resistance to Avastin in these tumors. So I've wanted to go into medicine ever since I was very young. It started when my Nana had cancer and I was first learning about that. Even at a young age, I knew I wanted to do something meaningful with my life, and that translated to me wanting to become a physician. Over the course of the years, I started developing my interests in neuroscience and neurology, and then subsequently neurosurgery. You know, I just kept going down that path. Studied in undergrad, was a neuroscience major, and just have never strayed away from that neuroscience. So we look at the tumor microenvironment, so the area around the tumor cells themselves, and how that may impact the development of resistance to the chemotherapeutic agent. I specifically look at microglia cells, which are a type of immune cell. And the theory is that these cells may not be attacking the tumor, that they may be helping the tumor become more invasive, because we found higher levels of microglia in the resistant tumors. We're looking at it using staining. I take actual tissue slices and I stain for different markers, one of which actually looks at the microglia cells and it picks up those cells. So I can use antibodies and fluorescent markers to look at it under the microscope. Another thing that we're doing now is genetic manipulation. So we use tools that allow us to take out genes out of cells, and then we can see how the cells behave when they don't have that gene involved. So you can see how fast they move, how fast they divide or invasion, how fast they move through tissue.
There's kind of like a break. There's cells over here, and then there's this kind of space, and then cells over here. And then we image it at various time points to see how quickly the cells close that gap.
The idea is that if we can find different genes that impact the way the tumor behaves, that we might be able to create a drug that can affect that. There is no cure for glioblastoma right now. And it's, you know, very unfortunate, but right now our primary goal is to improve the quality of life for these patients and also prolong their life. What we have to do is find out why these tumors aren't responding to different drugs. And if we figure out why, then we can combat those mechanisms.